Hey everybody, FX Fumble here, and today I want to talk to you about the Streamlight TLR1 HL. For years, I've used the TLR1 regular version. They fairly recently came out with the TLR1 HL, which is the 630 lumen version of the TLR1, and I was really excited to get my hands on one. Right now, it's sitting on my Glock Gen 3 G19. And I've used these on Glocks, I've used these on AKs and ARs, and basically any gun that has a rail on it. Now, let's talk about why do you want a weapon-mounted light? Well, to me, the answer is pretty obvious, especially on a home defense gun. You want to be able to see what you're shooting at before you take a shot, right? Just to make sure that we don't accidentally shoot somebody that doesn't need to be shot. Here's a close-up of the Streamlight TLR1 HL attached to my Glock Gen 3 G19 side-by-side with my old TLR1 regular version. Let's go ahead and get rid of that. Just wanted to show you that they are the exact same size. Let's go ahead and take this Streamlight off of the Glock 19. Okay, comes right off. Let's talk real quickly about how to mount this Streamlight TLR1 HL to any of your guns that have a rail system on it, okay? So you simply push this here, put that there. You're pretty much ready to go. All you really want to do from there is you can hand tighten this, but I like to have it, you know, nice and snug, so I just take a screwdriver and tighten it. To access the battery compartment on your Streamlight TLR1, you simply remove it from your firearm first. This little lip back here, you can flip up, which releases tension on the base plate, allowing you access to your two CR123 3-volt batteries. Installing new batteries is just as easy. Simply pop those back in there. This has a little lip right here. So you want to make sure you get that in there. And you're good to go. Now the Streamlight TLR1 has both momentary on and a mode where you can just flick this thing down and it goes on. Now for you right-handed guys, you're going to push down, and that's going to make your Streamlight TLR1 go constant on, but you can also do momentary on by pushing up. That does not lock the switch into place. Now, as you can see, it's by rotating this clockwise that we have on. So if you're left-handed, it would actually be pushing up with your left index finger, which would keep it on, and then pushing it down, which would be the momentary. If you want the option to only use the Streamlight TLR1 in a constant on, in other words, not the strobe, if you want the option to deactivate the strobe, it's very easy to do. You simply push the switch 10 times in a row and hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It will turn off then. Then, whenever you press the switch, your only option will be the constant on. Let's now do a brightness comparison between the TLR1 and the TLR1 HL. I also want to point out that these both take two 3-volt CR123 batteries. First, the TLR1. Now let's compare that to the TLR1 HL. Pretty dramatic. The Streamlight TLR1 HL does come equipped with four different rail keys, so you can mount it to pretty much any firearm. Right now, as you can see, I have the 1913 or Picatinny rail attachment in there. Also comes with one that says GL, stands for Glock. 92, which is for your Berettas. And TSW/99, which is for your Smith & Wessons. To change these out, it's very simple. You take your hex key, simply remove the one that's in there, then select whichever one you want to put back in. Of course, it's going to be a Glock. Retighten and you're good to go.
Let's take a look and see just how shockproof the Streamlight TLR1 HL is. Now, I don't recommend you guys do this to your TLR1. You don't want to void your warranty or do anything like that by misuse and abuse, but I'm going to do this so that we all know what these things can really take. Let's go ahead and turn it on. Okay, and up. Also got the GoPro set up down here by my feet, so you guys will be able to see the impact that this thing is having. All right, staying on. Yeah, this thing's doing absolutely great. Oops, I must have turned it off on accident, but still goes on. Okay, it just turned off, but. All right guys, so I've reattached the Streamlight TLR1 to my clock, 19 Gen 3, and I'm gonna drop it from up here, attach to the clock, and see if it can still take the impact. We'll go ahead and turn it on, even though it might turn off, but let's see if it can take it. Whoa, it fell like right on the end as well. Let's do one more time. I also have my GoPro set up down here by my feet so you can check it out. Yeah, and it's still on. I see no damage whatsoever. This Streamlight TLR1 is doing awesome. So I was checking out the side of my TLR1 HL box here, and one of the things it says it is it's IPX7 waterproof. Now, I don't really know what IPX7 is. I should probably look that up. Maybe I could Google it. But to me, I see the word waterproof, and I certainly know what that is. So, here, I've got some water. Here, I've got my Streamlight. Let's go ahead and turn it on. Okay. All right, that looks kind of cool, doesn't it? So as you can see, it's staying on. Whoa, that's kind of neat looking. Let's shake it up. Uh-oh. Well, it turned off. I'm not sure why. We'll find out here in a second. Oh, I like had a momentary on, I'm sure, from it just bumping the switch somewhere. Okay, so, take that out of there. Let's see here. Here we've got the Streamlight back up out of the water. Okay, so the switch turned off. That's why the light went off, I think. Let's try it. Yep, still working. Awesome. So your Streamlight TLR1 HL is waterproof. I hope you guys enjoyed my review and testing of the Streamlight TLR1 HL. I highly recommend this light. If you don't have a weapons mounted light yet, this is a good one to get initially because it's not as expensive as a lot of other competitive options are, but I believe the quality, durability, and usefulness are just as high as any of the other models. Streamlight does make other models as well. The reason I went with the Streamlight TLR1 HL, even though I already had a TLR1, is pretty simple. I already have all the holsters that fit the TLR1, so I didn't want to have to get a bunch of new holsters and stuff like that. I already have them. And like some of my favorite ones are the Dark Matter Tactical Kydex inside the waistband holster, and for outside the waistband holster that can accommodate the TLR1, I highly recommend the Dell Tac Concepts outside the waistband Kydex holster. Hope you guys enjoyed the review. TLR1 HL 630 lumens, powerful, great little light. Thanks for watching.